السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه was making طواف around the Kaaba, and there is this one person that was making طواف next to him, and he kept on repeating this dua. And سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب, after a while, he became curious, what is this all about? So he kept on saying, Allahumma ja'alni min al-qaleel, Allahumma ja'alni min al-qaleel, Allahumma ja'alni min al-qaleel. So Sayyidina Umar asked him, what is that? He said, haven't you read what Allah said in his book? وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. And few of my servants are actually thankful. So may Allah make me from the few, may Allah make me from the few, may Allah make me from the few. Maybe we have few people in the hall tonight, but alhamdulillah, it's usually few people who change history. You actually don't need many people to change history, and no one knows that better than Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends one messenger to change the reality of a whole nation. One. Just one. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees the necessity, He will send two. Musa and Harun. Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam and his son Sulaiman, Zakariya and Yahya. They were together at the same time. Rarely, as a matter of fact, one time in the Quran, in Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He sent three. وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا أَصْحَابَ الْقَرْيَةِ إِذْ جَاءَهَا الْمُرْسَلُونَ إِذْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمُ اثْنَيْنِ فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ. So Allah sent two messengers. They denied them. Allah supported them with a third one. Take two steps and look, brothers and sisters. Who is that one or two or three? Now imagine, mashallah, we have a room that has 200-300 people. That's more than enough. If we had a plan and we are sincere and dedicated to change not only the reality of Pleasanton, but probably the Bay Area, California, and the United States, and from there, the world. I don't like to talk big. I like to dream big. And I like to talk real. Subhanallah, brothers and sisters, we have at this time to dream big, but to start acting small. Yani, mashallah, you heard from the speech the principles of Islam. I believe, you know, as myself too, many of us here are immigrants. And I am proud to be an immigrant in a nation that is made of immigrants. There's nothing wrong with that. And many of us are actually going through rehab. Many of us are transforming from the beliefs and from the habits and from the convictions and from the way of life that we came with from our homes to come to this new land, a new opportunity, a new situation that Allah put us in to liberate ourselves from the old way of thinking. To the new way of thinking is a process, is not going to happen overnight, but the good news that it is actually happening. We're going through a group therapy, moving from fear. Usually in the countries around the world, third world countries, shh, don't talk about politics. We want to be safe. We don't want the Secret Service knocking our doors, right? If you see someone walking behind you, even in a park, you're like, why are you walking? We come with fears that have been instilled in us. But it takes time to liberate ourselves from these fears. And we can see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with children, and our children are growing up, knowing how to communicate with both worlds, with the world of their parents and with the world of the real streets out there. And they're able to accomplish. Subhanallah, brothers and sisters, someone like our brother Basim Al-Qarra, born and raised in San Francisco. He could have had a million successful jobs that would make him hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not millions. He chose to go and work with care. And until today, he could make at least 10 times of what he's making if he actually would practice with his degree. So this shows that the transformation is happening. Our sister here that will make 100 men shake and shiver, but yet with her, you know, femininity and with a smile, our sister Zahra Bilou, right? You know, she can call whoever you want her to call, the FBI, the CIA, the police, anything, any agency, the national intelligence services, and she will speak with strength and with no fear. The good news, brothers and sisters, is the change is happening. And every time the change is happening, the people who don't like that change will get louder and louder, as you can see. People thought like, whoa, after 8 years of George Bush, that's it. Muslims are gone. They're done. Unacceptable. Unaccepted in this reality. But subhanAllah, you know, I know he's not a Muslim and I don't believe he's a Muslim. But for a president to come after 8 years of George Bush, and his name is Barack Hussein Obama, is a lesson for those who need a lesson from history. And for him to appoint people in his cabinet, from Sister Dalia Mujahid to Brother Shahid, who's a Hafiz, who was appointed to the world, Muslim World Organization, to this and that, to the White House staff, people are Muslims. People bet that we're not going to do that. It was after September 11 that the first Muslim congressman was elected to the United States House of Representatives, Brother Keith Ellison. And very soon, with the election of President Obama, another African-American representative from the state of Indiana, Northwest Indiana, was elected, and he was a practicing Muslim. And Keith Ellison survived all the attacks, the vicious attacks, uniting the Muslim, the Black, the Latino, and the Jewish vote, and he's still winning year in, year out. When did that happen? After everyone was betting that Muslims will be finished. That's why, brothers and sisters, the future is bright for those who think that it is bright. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And our hope is not in our whatever we do. Our hope lies in God and in the help of God to us, inshallah Rabbil Alameen. When you talk about these big ideas have to start from small places. Small places, you know, one time we used to say MCC was small. Now we can't say it's small because you're talking about 40 some thousand square feet. But MCC, when you talk about the activities, you have to do simultaneous things at the same time in order for the community to survive and prosper and grow and do what it's supposed to do. You have to take care of the new generation, the children. Oh my God, when I went and visited MCC in their weekend school graduation last year, 400 children. I mean, do you understand? That's an entire generation. 400 children in that school, and they have a waiting list. You know, do you know how lucky we are? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the Prophet comes on the Day of Judgment and only 10 people listen to him, only. Everybody else said, we don't like you. You're backwarded, ridiculous. We don't understand you. You talk about God, but we're not interested. Get out. The Prophet comes on the Day of Judgment with 9, 8, 7. And the Prophet went up to 1. And he said, the Prophet comes on the Day of Judgment with no one believing in him. By himself, just standing on the Day of Judgment, no one believed. 400 children. I mean, do you know what that would mean to a prophet? A prophet, not us. Now imagine when you take, this is the weekend school. Add to that the crowd of Salat al-Jum'ah. Now we have 2 full-time Salat al-Jum'ah in MCC. Add to that the women activities and the women halaqas. Add to that our brothers and sisters, you know, in Rahma, which they gather the children. And, you know, I live in Santa Clara. And my wife would drive from Santa Clara on Sunday last year just to MCC, just to join the girls of Rahma and sit down and learn about Allah and make some nasheed and beat the daf. And
she cannot wait the whole week. I mean, she goes to an Islamic school, full-time Islamic school, and still she cannot wait till Sunday comes so that she can go and join the Rahma girls at MCC. I mean, do you understand? It's like 35, 40 minutes drive, especially if there is traffic. You're talking about an hour. Brothers and sisters, there are activities in MCC, alhamdulillah, that people gravitate towards these activities day in. And I can go on and on and on. On the top of that, they are able to rent some of the space and generate income. As far as I'm concerned, I don't know a single Islamic center in the Bay Area or in California that generates $25,000 in rent a month. Congratulations to our brother and sister at MCC. Please give them a hand. Now that's the way to do it. You want to know how Islam's, Muslims and mosques should function? Go to Turkey. They build the masjid, then they build a huge bazaar around it. And next to the masjid, the rooms for the imams and the muaddin. Then the rooms for the students. Then the school. Then the market. And then all of the markets and its waqf endowment supports the masjid and the school and the imam and the cleanliness and the renovation and the remodeling. We need to bring that back again. And alhamdulillah, we are very close to that point at MCC in which we will have inshallah zero debt, and inshallah we will start making income that will cover a large part of the operation, because right now part of that $25,000 goes back to paying off Al-Qard Al-Hasan. I mean, MCC as of today, and please Brother Asif and Brother Azhar Siddiqui, correct me if I'm wrong, MCC as of today owes $0 to the bank for the loan that they took, $1.8 million. Am I right or wrong? Am I right or wrong? Please give them a hand of applause. Jazakumullah khair. I mean, fundraising after fundraising, you wonder where your money went? Try to buy this property today. Where they bought it for $4 million, try to buy it for $8 million. Try to buy it for $12 million today. The value of that property is already, alhamdulillah, and it happened in the right time. We bought in the right time and we sold the other land in the right time. And I'm a witness, you know, brother here keeps on meeting me and says, remember the first fundraising for MCC when we fundraised for that land, you were there. I said, brother, not the first and the middle and the second and the third and the tenth and today the last. I'm always there. I mean, come on. It's like I know when the fundraising of MCC more than I know my birthday. Come on, people. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. It's there on the calendar. Brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, we are able to make history. Because look, in the South Bay, we started having huge. We know MCA was there, and now we added, mashaAllah, SBIA and Masjid al-Mustafa, 70,000 square feet. I mean, do you think these places are doing nothing? They are making history silently. You go to SBIA and Rahima, you know, foundation is sitting there giving food for everyone, Muslim or not. Well, how do you think people make history? By sitting down and just praying? You have to get down to the level, to the grassroots level, and start making the society problems, youth problem, and you have a solution. Because people of faith have a solution. They have compassion. They have love. They have mercy. They care. And brothers and sisters, you might not see the change like overnight. Oh, we did this today. Tomorrow, it's the whole change. The Muslim situation in America has changed. It wouldn't be for the sake of God if that happened. But Allah tests you and tests you and tests you. And slowly but surely, things are getting better and better and better. Including the candidacy of Donald Trump. It's one of the best news that happened to Muslims in the recent history. This guy is amazing. He has united us with everybody else. Thank you, Donald Trump. It's equal opportunity. Now, Muslims, blacks, Jews, Latinos, south of the border, north of the border, we're all on the same. Thank you very much. Jazakallah khair for what you're doing. Every time you're pointing one finger at someone else, you're pointing three at yourself. You know, what are you doing? He's doing group therapy. People come, oh, so mad at Barack Obama, the black Muslim president, we're gonna change it. They come charged, they're ready, you know, and then he comes and gives them group therapy, talks. They all feel good and they go home good. So he's just doing like Dr. Phil, you know? Do you remember Dr. Phil and Oprah? He's another Dr. Phil. Group therapy. Dr. Phil does it individually. Donald Trump does it on a group level. Thank you very much. You know? But, you know, this is not going to go anywhere, brothers and sisters. Even if he wins the presidency, he has to change. Because America will not tolerate that. I mean, subhanAllah, if the Republicans are looking at him and say, he's vulgar, he's vicious, he's this, okay, wow. If the Republicans are saying that, someone is learning a lesson. Brothers and sisters, you know, we are here to deal with everyone, Republicans, Democrats. That's not our business in the masjid. Our business is to serve everyone, to serve those who are in need, and to walk in the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, I really feel like every year a Muslim should dedicate a month just reviewing the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wallahi, it will give you hope, it will give you focus, it will give you direction. One man trying to change an entire peninsula, an entire nation that led to the change of the world. The amount of aggression, oppression, discrimination, women oppression, slave oppression, weak oppression, the right and left oppression, for him to start with what? With service, with compassion, and try to find, are you compassionate? Yes, come and join me. Are you compassionate? Yes, come and join me. Are you compassionate? Yes, please help us out. And he will get people started embracing Islam. And people made fun of them. And people tortured them. And people killed them. I mean, we are facing nothing comparing to that generation. That's why we say, radiyallahu anhum wa ardahum. It's unbelievable what they went through. I mean, imagine the mentality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The entire situation around him is pitch black, bleak, nothing, doom and gloom. And he has this vision in his head. This is going to be bright. And everything goes against that vision in his head. And people telling him, what are you talking about? You coming to change Arabia? You don't know the Arabs? And he's like, yeah, I know. You don't know how dark is the picture? No. But I see the vision. And he refused to look at the ugly reality. He kept on looking at the vision, focusing, until he stood up in his final speech in Khutbat Hajjat al-Wada' and gave the historical human rights declaration for all Muslims and for all humanity. And he told them, listen to me, for maybe I will not see you after this year. Let me spill it out to you. Let me. And when you read Khutbat Hajjat al-Wada', it's nothing but human right after human right after human right, destroying the traditions of Jahiliyyah that is built on oppression and building the traditions of Islam that is built on justice. Brothers and sisters, if you don't learn the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every year, once a year, you know, when I was a child, people talk about the Milad. Do you know what was the Milad for us? For an entire month, we will have, you go to the masjid and you hear the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You go to the masjid and you hear the seerah. And at the end of the month comes the Milad and then you celebrate. By then, you are an expert on the seerah. Year in, year out. The Milad was a revision of the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Libya. I'm talking Benghazi. You know Benghazi? Where Hillary Clinton is from? That's where I was born and raised. You know, Malikis to the core. Warsh Riwaya to the core. And Qalun too. And you know, it's unbelievable. And you go there, we children were not allowed in the masjid to walk in and play. I mean, it's the day of judgment if you walk in and play in the masjid when you were a kid. Not like today, we're like, please come to the masjid, we'll give you candy. The only candy, the only time we were allowed to walk in and play and eat cake and drink juice in the masjid was at the time of the Milad of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya'ni, they made us fall in love with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam just through that event of the Milad. May Allah reward them. It's an entire generation that passed away. And now what we're getting, the literalists, the people who want to kill him, even if they find a qabr of a Muslim who's dead, they'll blow up the qabr. Ajib wallah. So you blow up the dead. You blow up the living, also the dead? Yani, this is interesting, you know. One time I saw a caricature, you know, it's saying, you know, someone is trying to teach, you know, the children, you know, suicide bombing. So he's telling them, listen and listen very well. I'm going to only do this once. You know, which Islam are you learning? I mean, come on, people. What did we get out of that? People love their deen? No, we didn't. That entire generation, Libya under Gaddafi, because these places were allowed to exist, graduated some of the largest number of huffaz, memorizers of the Book of Allah. When the relationship got better between the United States and Libya, and they allowed the Libyan students to come here, They became the free qaris in almost every masjid leading Salat al-Taraweeh with beautiful voices. And he would ask him, where did you come from? Libya. Qaddafi? Yeah, Qaddafi. You memorized the Quran? Yeah, I do memorize the Quran. Entire generation of memorizers of the Quran, because there was some religious freedom for these events to happen. Now what? So brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, history is coming and history is changing. Alhamdulillah, we are spoiled, you know. We're sitting in Marriott, you know, chicken breast dinner. You know, you can get vegetarian if you don't want, on a very nice table, very nice screens. But we're still changing history. Life and money did not spoil us. Money is the means that we get closer to God, not far away from God. And this is why we are here tonight, to make silently history, day by day, with our sweat and blood. Islam, one of the most amazing things in Islam. Wallahi, it's beautiful. From the days, 1400 years ago, the first principle, money, time is money, is an Islamic principle. Prophetic principle. Khulafa al-Rashideen principle. Time is money. Time is money. When Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan paid the imam, the first one who paid the muazzin and then the imam, some people told him, you pay them for leading salah? He said, no, I don't pay them for leading salah. God will pay them that. I pay them for holding them hostage in the masjid and not allowing them to do any other job, because time is money. That's why I'm paying them as an imam and muazzin. I'm paying them for the time, not for the job. Time is money. To be paid for mental anguish and emotional distress sounds very 21st century. You know, someone came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was a Jewish man, verifying the description of Rasulullah in the Torah. He came, he gave loan to the Prophet. And the Prophet ﷺ did not have a problem dealing with money with the Jews. Most of the loans that the Prophet ﷺ did, including the day he died, he borrowed from the Jews and he gave them back the money. So the man came to him and pulled him and said, you family of Abdul Muttalib. He didn't only insult the Prophet, he insulted his entire tribe. Yani for an Arab, that's the end of the world. That's the day of judgment, that's the day I die. Right? You family of Abdul Muttalib, you take money and you never pay it back on time. Umar ibn Khattab took the sword out and said, let me just chop off his head right now, Ya Rasulullah. The man saw the sword, you know, illuminating under the sun. He started shaking and shivering. Rasulullah said, put back your sword. You could have done something better. You could have asked me to pay him on time, and you could have asked him to ask me nicely, better than your sword. Ya Umar, since this is what you have done, now I'm going to borrow the money from you. You go and pay the Jewish man the money. And by the way, get closer. And he got closer. And Rasulullah ﷺ say, pay him 10 dinar. Like we're talking about 10 pieces of gold extra. He said, why, Ya Rasulullah? He said, that's a payment for how you got him scared, for him being scared of you. Paid for mental anguish and emotional distress. Sayyidina Umar looked at the Prophet. The Prophet said, Umar, go and pay him. So he went and gave him, and he finally said, this is 10. He said, Allahu Akbar, you're giving me more? He said, it's not because of me, it's because of him. Just, you know, in check. He said, the Prophet said, because I scared you. He said that. He said, yes. He said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. That's the description of this Prophet in our Torah. That's what I was looking for. Brothers and sisters, we need, as the brother said, to go back to that. We have it in us. We can do it. Wallahi, we can do it. But it takes step by step. And without institutions and without education and without all of that, it's not going to happen. You are making history and you don't know it. Huge centers that are graduating generation after generation. That's why, brothers and sisters, you know, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah, Allah has blessed your community. And I know we have few. I would like to start, before I do the fundraising, with seeing if anyone would like to bless this effort, this humble endeavor and effort for the sake of Allah to change our reality and the reality around us. Someone who can help us with $50,000, inshallah, today. Someone who would like to make history. Someone who gives money with love, not gives money with pressure. Gives money because he loves Allah, she loves Allah. Because money, they earn money, but they spend it. They have no problem spending it because of that love and connection. You know how much money is beloved to the human? I'll tell you how much money is beloved to the human. The human is willing to die for his money. And it doesn't make sense. You know why? Because if you die, you're not going to enjoy that money. How in the world do you die defending your money? When you die, you're not going to even enjoy it. But money is more beloved to the human than his own life and soul. That's why Allah said in the Quran, struggle in the name of Allah with your money and with yourselves. And Allah mentioned money before the self, because it's more dear to you. Imagine what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that to struggle and to give because Allah gave you a guarantee. I'm telling you, Allah gave you a guarantee. What's the guarantee? You are going to donate tonight. And every night you donated before. Allah is not going to allow it that you donate and He doesn't give it back to you. It's not going to happen. He will not allow it. Why? Because Allah will not allow anyone in any moment of history to be more generous than Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Exalted is He. So in the same nanosecond you said, I'm going to give 50,000. Allah said, no, hold on. Before you do that, I'm going to give you back 100,000. And Allah never gives back the same. And I'm talking reward in dunya, not akhirah. I'm talking about reward in dunya. And I say this, not because I want to emotionally pump you, because I have heard stories upon stories. People that attended fundraisings came back after a month or two, 6 months, next fundraising, and they told me stories that are mind-boggling. Like, unbelievable things happen when people make a covenant with Allah and say, here is Ya Allah, I give fi sabila. So before I start the fundraising and asking people to donate, I just want to see someone who would like to give fi sabilillah, because every community has heavy, heavy donors. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam at his days, Abu Bakr was a heavy donor. Uthman ibn Affan was a heavy donor. Abdurrahman ibn Auf was a heavy donor. Who else? The first donor in Islam, the woman that first believer, first woman that made, first person on the planet that made wudu and salah was Khadija bint Khuwaylid radiallahu ta'ala. I don't know if you know that. Right after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we will be discussing this inshallah in our seerah starting tomorrow for 2 weeks at SBIA, may Allah reward them. They opened the doors and MCC opened the doors. Inshallah for 2 weeks, you can come in person, you can attend live streaming, you can attend the recording whenever you want. You don't even have to attend it on live streaming. But every year we have to have a seerah for at least a month discussing the life of the Prophet to remind ourselves and to connect ourselves to the roots. The first woman, Rasulullah, goes with angel Jibreel, Gabriel, to the mountain. He hits the mountain with his heels. The water gushes out. Jibreel takes a form of a human, makes wudu. Rasulullah makes wudu. Jibreel alayhi salam stands up. Rasulullah stands up next to him. Jibreel prays 2 rak'ah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa pray next to him 2 rak'ah. And Jibreel looked at him and he said, that is your prayers and the prayers of the prophets that came before you. Now go and teach your ummah. Rasulullah goes home and the first one that did wudu and salah was Khadija bint Khuwaylid radiallahu ta'ala. Imagine this woman. Imagine this pillar dedicated herself, financed Rasulullah from day one. You don't do the job, I'll make the money, you go and make da'wah. This is how Islam happened. If Rasulullah didn't have Khadija, Abu Bakr, Uthman, Abdurrahman ibn Auf, Bani Abu Talib himself and Ali Sayyidina Ali, they put their everything they have fi sabilillah, subhanallah. How would have Islam started? I know some people say, why do I have to donate 50,000? Don't say why. Say, alhamdulillah, I am the one who can donate 50,000. Not why. Thank you, Allah, for enabling me to give $50,000. So do I have anyone before we start? Someone with love. As Allah said, they give what they give with love. Not to be thanked, not to be recognized, but for the love of Allah. And they have a relationship with Allah. Every time they give, Allah give them back. Every time they give, Allah give them back. Every time they give, Allah give them back. And that's why the brother said, courageousness is a muscle. Develop the muscle. You might have never stood up in your life and said something courageous. Try it out. You're not going to die. Nothing is going to happen to you. But you develop the muscle. Also, giving is a muscle. If you've never given in your life, you'll think, oh my God, if I give, I will be bankrupt. My bank account will go to zero and I'm fried. I'm done. No. You will not be fried, inshallah. You will be in na'im. Nadrat in na'im. Allah will give you the nadra of na'im. Your face will illuminate. Your health will progress. Do I have one? I just want to get that out of the way. Because subhanAllah, every fundraising in MCC, we had someone to donate $50,000. Either he forgive it from the Qard Hassan, or he give it as a check, or he give it as a, 401k or whatever you know, URA or all of these things. Somehow, they're giving, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah. And Brother Asif just told me that the MCC now president is our sister, mashallah, here. So we're following the footsteps of Khadija radiallahu anha. And she comes with what? With a British accent, so don't mess around with her. She's going to get to you, you know. You don't mess around with the sister. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. May Allah reward you. Do I have any donor? Do I have anyone that would like to bless us and ignite the night? And everyone that donates after you today, you will get a copy of their hasanat. If we raise 300,000 tonight, Allah will count it that you didn't donate 50,000, that you donated 300,000. So please help us out, brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable you and give you, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah. It's not too much, brothers and sisters. It's too little. How many 50,000 have you made since you've came to the United States of America? Or since you started your job? Some people, they make $50,000 a year. Some people, they make $50,000 a month. And that's the fadl of Allah. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Who are you, our first donor, or, you know, the igniter of tonight? Anyone would like to take that? Anyone? If you don't want to raise your hand and you want to text any of the brothers, Brother Zuhair Siddiqui, Brother Asif, you know, and or Brother Pervez Qureshi, if you want to tell them, we can do that, because I don't want to spend so much time. I just have witnessed with my own eyes almost every fundraising, there is someone who gave $50,000. So I just want to give the chance to the people. Do I have anyone? Anyone in the name of Allah? Bismillah. Tawakkalna ala Allah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Subhanallah. That's okay. That's okay, because I haven't started my fundraising, so I'm not disheartened. I'm just like, you know, having fun with you, inshallah, and giving a chance of ulul fadl and ulul albab and ulul absar to come forward. And as-sabiqoon, as-sabiqoon. Allah talks about these people in Al-Quran. There are people who always come first, alhamdulillah, and they have gotten us used to be first, mashallah. Where are you? First donor, 50? Mashallah, la quwwata illa billah. Anyone? Mashallah. Anyone would like to make history and help us out? Alhamdulillah. Tayyib, if we cannot have one person with $50,000, which I know it will come at the end of the night, it always does, do I have two people that will help each other to together become $50,000? 25 and 25. Anyone? Any two people? MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. Any two people? Alhamdulillah. Any two people? One, two, 25, 25. That's okay. InshaAllah, Allah will give us whatever is in our rizq tonight. No one is stressed out here. We are just trying to fulfill our pledge with the people who gave loans to the masjid, to honor them. Because then our institutions will never receive loans if we default on our loans. So, مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفُهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. Who would give Allah a good loan? Imagine Allah goes down to our level, human level, and Allah says, listen, if you don't want to donate, forget it. Just give me a loan. I'll pay it off. عجيب, huh? It's very interesting how Allah speaks to a level where the human beings understand. If you don't want to donate, don't donate. Give me a loan. I will give it back to you many folds. And it will not be riba. It will be barakah. Fadl from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do I have two people with 25,000? One and two? Do I have two people with 25,000? MashaAllah. Any two people? MashaAllah. Maybe the people in the back, they can update us and tell us something. Maybe inshallah, because envelopes are coming, and I am just here, as Allah said, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطَرْ. Remind, you're only a reminder. You have no control over them. I have no control. Allah has control over you. Just let Allah do the miracle. SubhanAllah, brothers and sisters, when it rains, the rain goes and finds where open channels are. It goes find open channel. If it finds open channel, the rain will make the channel wider and bigger, because more rain is going down, more rain. If the channel, for whatever reason, closes and gets clogged, the water will back off and will find somewhere else to go from. Exactly the story of rizq. Allah sends people rizq. The one who gives more,
His channel becomes bigger, Allah gives him more. It rains more on his side.
The second he closes the channel, the rizq will back up, and Allah will send the rizq to someone else. And that's the lesson we learn, brothers and sisters. So do I have two people with $25,000, some two channels of rahmah, of ata, of sakha from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Let Allah use you as a channel of His mercy and of His support, inshaAllah. As you know, the ulama used to make dua, Ya Allah, make us keys that opens the gates of goodness and locks that locks the gates of evil. Huh? Ya Allah, make us keys that opens the gates of goodness and locks that locks the gates of evil. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Who wants to be a key today? Do we have anything? Alhamdulillah. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. That's okay, because we haven't started the fundraising yet. MashaAllah. Okay, brothers and sisters. Alhamdulillah, I know, MashaAllah, from my experience from before, the donation keeps coming and we never fail. We've never walked out of a fundraising that was a failure at MCC. Alhamdulillah, we've always walked winners. So I am full confidence, you know, I have full confidence that inshallah tonight we will succeed and do well as we always do. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Brothers and sisters, if we have 10 people in the room, you know, each one will donate $10,000. We will end up with $100,000. You see, I asked for 50, I'm confident I'm going to get the 50. I asked for 225s, I'm confident that I'm going to get 225s, inshallah. So that's 100,000. I want to move to the second 100,000. I need 10 people, each with $10,000. Who will help us out, brothers and sisters? If you don't know, if you don't believe, go to the MCC and look with your own eyes. Look with your own eyes, brothers and sisters. It's unbelievable. So, if you see the hundreds upon hundreds of youth and children and activities and women activities and serving and making da'wah, interfaith activities, talking to the neighbors, visiting other churches coming and visiting. It's a whole rainbow of good deeds, amal salih, of activities. And everyone, Allah uses him to where he's good at. And that's very beautiful. So I want, inshallah, 10 people, each one with $10,000. Do I have anyone, alhamdulillah, with $10,000? Do I have anyone, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah, with $10,000? So that we can roll for the next 100,000, alhamdulillah, and we will be able to reach our goal, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Brothers and sisters, remember where you stand. Remember where you are. You are in the Bay Area. The whole world looks up to the Bay Area. This is where history gets made. Do you know where the idea of community colleges came from? It actually came from Berkeley. The idea of having 2 years community college, which is all over the nation, started from here. Brothers and sisters, we have Google here, Apple, Facebook, Twitter, and all the other, Oracle, Cisco, for God's sake, I mean, it's unbelievable. Every company that does large scale change in the world is here, close to you. We underestimate our effect on the rest of the world. You know, when I go Malaysia, you know, Singapore, Indonesia, and I tell them, you know, I tell them, do you know where's our location? Where next to them? Oh my God. The entire dialogue changes. The entire interaction changes, subhanAllah. The rest of the world is looking up to us here. Wallahi al-azim, brothers and sisters. Yani, in Muslim countries, they wish to have the type of Islamic centers we have here. You know, Muslim countries, you go to Malaysia, you go to Singapore, you go to Indonesia. They say, we wish we have the way you attract your youth in the Islamic centers in America. In Turkey, brothers and sisters, it's a majority Muslim country. But the youth there, when they hear, how do we deal with the masajid here and how we have activities for everyone and camping and watching movies and go bowling and go paintballing and go this? They go crazy. You do that in the masjid? Yeah. Do you know if we do this in the masjid, they'll shoot us, they'll kill us. You know, if you go to Pakistan, many of you here are from Hyderabad. And I visited Hyderabad like 3-4 times. Spoke in front of like 100,000 people. Unbelievable. And they all like, what can we do with our youth? What can we do? We're losing them. They're not coming to the masjid. I said, you need to do what we're doing. Tell me what we're doing. I said, I'm not going to tell you. I want you tomorrow to advertise on TV. They have a channel that there will be an event only and only for high schoolers. No middle school is allowed. No college student is allowed. Subhanallah, like 1,000 youth showed up. Because you started targeting, they felt, oh, you're talking only to high school. Next day, we said, we're going to only have an event for college students. Oh my God, Osmaniyah University. My God, it was full from as far as your eyes can see. Because people don't know how to do these activities. I'm telling you, we're making history. We're changing the world. If in the Muslim world, they start doing what we do here in America, the entire understanding of religion will change. I mean, you know, people have come with this interpretation of the hadith, a positive interpretation of the hadith. The hadith says, the day of judgment will not come until the sun rises from the west. The sun every day rises from the east. Until the sun rises from the west, the day of judgment will not come. So some interpreted it in a positive way. They say the sun is the truth. And Islam rose the first time from the east. The second time, Islam will rise from the west. We're looking for a beautiful sign, not a horrible sign. Until the sun rises from the west, it means until Islam flourishes from the west again. Because, you know, sometimes you go to the east, they're so stuck in tradition, they can't see the truth anymore. Truth or tradition, I'll take the truth. Truth or culture, I'll take the truth. Truth or whatever I think is right, I'll take the truth. And the truth is, Islam is very attractive to all ages. This is the solution, brothers and sisters. You know, you feel sometimes you want to scream loud. You see now, the new weapon of ISIS is using children. And subhanAllah, how else the solution is, except in Iraq and in Syria, children are attracted to the masjid like they're attracted at MCA and MCC and SBIA and Saratoga. That is the solution to the ISIS problem. What we do here is a solution. You don't see it in the big picture. You think, oh, the small masjid, what are we doing? This is the solution. This is the solution. Our children here are on the front run of technology. I mean, mashallah, in Saratoga, we have kids in the masjid that made a robot and went to Amazon, said, would you take my robot to deliver? You know how they said now they're going to deliver packages with Amazon through robots. They made a robot like a quadcopter that has the four fans. Unbelievable Muslim children. One of the Muslim children, Eritrean, mashallah, may Allah bless his parents and bless him. His heart is in the masjid. He came to me and said, Sheikh, would you like to come to one of my classes? I come to your classes. Why don't you come to my class? I said, I'll come. How old are you? He said, I am 13 turning 14. I said, and what class do you teach? He said, I teach how do 3D printers work and how to do 3D printing. I said, okay, where, in your middle school? He said, no, I teach the class at Stanford University. I said, you teach who? He said, graduates and undergraduates. I said, and how in the world? He said, when I was 9 years old, I got attracted to it. And now I am like a world resource to 3D printing. I have 14 3D printers at home. I said, can you print me a car? He started laughing. He said, Sheikh, pretty soon I will be able to do that. But right now I can print you a hammer. We can even, there are printers that print actually with bacteria. It prints cells, like actual cells, a living thing, it prints with a 3D printer. He started talking to me. I just gave him a hug. Alhamdulillah that we have amongst our youth people who are like that. There is a young person in Fresno, a young Muslim, you know, high schooler, had the perfect score, not a single answer wrong on SAT and ACT. Full score. One kid in both exams, he walked in 100%. They interviewed him on every channel. This is the solution to the world's problem. This is the solution to the youth, to the Muslim youth worldwide. We provide the example. Don't think small, think big. That's why, brothers and sisters, yani, alhamdulillah, don't belittle what we're doing in these Islamic centers. You might think, oh, it's a small thing. No, it's a big thing. These institutions are big and huge. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah, tabarakallah. So, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Do I have anyone with $10,000? MashaAllah. Alhamdulillah. That's okay. That's okay. A lot of the donors did not come tonight to the dinner, but inshallah, they will donate. And the caravan will continue to travel. And the journey will continue to be traveled. And no center will stop because of, lack of funds. There is no lack of funds in our Muslim community. Alhamdulillah, there's plenty of funds. I'm just trying to think, what's next, brothers and sisters? Do you know how many young men and women in the Bay Area that have started a company and sold it for hundreds of millions of dollars? You want to know? On March 22nd, I'm inviting every one of them that I can get my hand on. I'm inviting every one of them to come and give a speech, 15 minutes, their life story. People who sold their companies, 400 million, 500 million, 750 million. And so far, I've got so many confirmations, and they are excited to meet the Muslim community. Because we always tell them to come to the masjid, they come and pray, they leave. But they were never able to, given the chance to do something, they don't know what to do. So I said, come and tell us your story. That's what I want you to do. May 22nd, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. We're going to have a seminar of success and leadership. From middle school, high school, college students, men, women, sisters who want to start non-for-profit organizations, brothers who want to do some business, start an app, start a company, you will get a consultation from people that if you go in the real world, they wouldn't meet you in 6 months and they wouldn't give you 5 minutes. But they are our Muslim brothers and sisters in our community, and they're more than happy to do that, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So, you see, you just have to ask, and Allah gives. We got $25,000. Takbir. You think it's dry? It's not dry. Alhamdulillah, it's raining. The drought is over. We have El Nino right now. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Make sure you don't get wet on the way out, inshallah. Or if you want to follow the sunnah of the Prophet, when the rain used to fall in the beginning of the season, he used to stand up in the middle of the rain and get soaked. And he used to say, this rain was just born. It's pure and sinless. It was just born. It has just came to existence and it's freshly glorifying its Lord. So he would walk in the masjid, and the masjid at the time of the Prophet didn't have a rug or carpet. It was mud. And after salah, people used to laugh. Salaamu alaikum, salaamu alaikum, and then used to laugh because their faces were full of mud. And their hands were full of mud, and their knees were full of mud. And sometimes they would splash the water on each other inside al-Masjid al-Nabawi al-Sharif. And the Prophet ﷺ would look at the Sahaba and smile, and they would laugh. SubhanAllah, brothers and sisters, such a humble place with no carpet graduated some of the greatest men and women in history. SubhanAllah. That's the lesson that we get. It's not about the walls, it's about the people. And you have some nice people, very welcoming people. MashaAllah, I've never approached MCC to do a seminar, to do anything. They said, Sheikh, come, the center is your center. Open wide. Whatever you want. MashaAllah. May Allah reward them. Same thing, SBIA, MashaAllah. They said, come, the center is yours. MashaAllah. MCA, come. It's open doors. MashaAllah. We don't have ill feelings. We don't have hatred. We help each other. Every fundraising, all the masajid help each other, mashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. That's beautiful. Yasin Foundation, come, youth, Yasin Youth, you know, center in Burlingame. You know, next time when you're landing, look to the left. If you're landing in San Francisco Airport, look to the left. You're going to see Yasin Youth Center. You can get there, stop there on the way back from the airport or on the way to the airport. You can stop by and pray two rak'ah. SubhanAllah. We are spreading silently. People are beating, but we are minding our own business and doing what we're supposed to do. And we're hurting no one. We are benefiting everyone. We're not hurting anyone. We're benefiting, alhamdulillah, the Muslim and the non-Muslim. One event after another, mashaAllah. Just in the last 2-3 months in Yassin Foundation, they've invited the churches and the officials, and you do that here. No one will stop us, inshallah, la quwwata illa billah. So, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Do we have 10 people with 10,000, mashallah? Anyone with $10,000? Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. MashaAllah la quwwata illa billah. Tayyib, they're doing the calculation, inshallah. I really appreciate one thing, that you sat down and you had sabr. Fundraising succeed not because people give money, it's because they sit down and have sabr, because Allah says, Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin. You might not donate yourself, but the fact that you sit down and listen encourages someone else to donate. So don't think that by you sitting down and listening is a waste of time. A'udhu billah. This is how we support, at least the least. They say, be where Allah would like you to be, and do not ever show yourself to Allah where He doesn't want you to be. Be where Allah wants you to be. And you are here. There is no better place to be in other than this place or another fundraising that is supporting a house of Allah and a community center. You are exactly where Allah wants to find you. That's beautiful. You will find Allah exactly when you need Him. You will find Him because He found you exactly when He wanted you, and where He wanted you, He found you there. You will find Him there when you need Him. Subhanallah. Allah doesn't need us, but we need Him. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So, do I have the next level of donation? Alhamdulillah, $5,000. They are calculating and they're continuing, inshallah, while we are encouraging each other and doing watawasaw bil haqqi watawasaw bil sabr. What we're doing here is watawasaw bil haqqi watawasaw bil sabr. You know, let me tell you about a fundraising Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam did. Rasulullah sent a letter to the king of Rome, Caesar. He said, this is from Muhammad, the son of Abdullah, to Caesar, the king of Rome. If you become Muslim, Allah will give you peace and Allah will reward you for you and your nation. If you deny Islam, you will be judged on the day of judgment on your behalf and on behalf of your nation. Wassalamu alaikum. Bas, I am inviting you to Islam. In answer to that one letter, Rome sent 3 armies. The first army is the army of Mu'tah. The second army is the army of Tabuk. And the third army is the army when the Prophet ﷺ was dying. He sent them a letter. Just welcome. I invite you to Islam. If you accept, you accept. If you are not accept, you're going to be responsible in front of Allah. They said, oh, who are you to talk to us like that? Who are you? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in the second wave, they sent 250,000 soldiers, Roman soldiers, to wipe out Muslims in Medina. Rasulullah said, if we wait for them to come to Medina, we're all dead. We have to come and meet them northern. Rasulullah stood up. There is no food, no camels, nothing. Stood up and made fundraising. The Sahaba had a difficult 2 years with no rain in Medina. Rasulullah stood up. Who will give? Who will give? Who will give? No one has anything to give. Everybody said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm bringing myself, I'm bringing my camel. The money that I have is enough to feed my family and help me with the journey to go with you. I'm going nowhere, I'm going with you. But I don't have money to give. So they couldn't raise their hand. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan saw the Prophet asking, and nobody's answering. Nobody. Rasulullah is doing fundraising, nobody. People don't have. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, whatever the total number of your fundraising, I will give 1/3 of it. 1/3 of the total fundraising, it's on me. Rasulullah said, Jazakallah khair ya Uthman, barakallahu fi. Rasulullah started doing fundraising, asking, encouraging. Nobody's raising his hand. They say until the eyes of Rasulullah became red. Because no microphones, so he's speaking, making everyone. Sayyidina Uthman stood up and said, Ya Rasulullah, I ask you by Allah, take it easy on yourself. The total fundraising, the 2/3 is on me. Please just sit down. Rasulullah said, okay, we are 1/3 away. Fundraising. Nobody stood up. Sayyidina Uthman said, until the voice of Rasulullah was gone, حتى بح صوته صلى الله عليه وسلم. He stood up and said, Ya Rasulullah, the final one third is on me. For Allah's sake, sit down. خلاص. It's enough. Do you know what Rasulullah said something? Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan reminded people of what Rasulullah said when they came to kill him. He said, one day Rasulullah looked me in the eye and said, Uthman shall not worry whatever he does for the rest of his life. Allah has forgiven him. مَا عَلَىٰ عُثْمَان مَا صَنَعَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ Uthman shall never worry about whatever he does for the rest of his life. I'm a witness that Allah has forgiven him. Because of one fundraising dinner, one fundraising event, people who came to kill Sayyidina Uthman because they were not happy with his style of khilafah, what did they end up with? This is the literalist. You're not good enough. You're not a good Muslim enough. You're not strict enough. You're not following the Quran. You're not following the Sunnah. Abu Bakr died as a victim to that. I mean, Uthman ibn Khattab, Uthman died as a victim to that. And even Ali, the cousin of the Prophet, the husband of Fatima, the father of Al-Hazm al-Hussein, was not still good enough in the eyes of these people. Literalist, literalist, literalist. Ya Ali, you are a kafir. Na'udhu billah. Why? You didn't put Quran as judgment. You asked to the judgment of human beings, not Allah. Who are you to talk to Ali ibn Abi Talib like that? Karramallahu wajah. Who are you? You see, this literalism and this fanaticism, extremism, from the days of the Khulafa, it did us no good. But you know what's the good news? Always Islam prevails and survives and comes back to its moderation. Those people that are trying to think, if we kill more people and we make Islam stricter, we make it, it's going to become better and we're going to have the Khilafa. They're going to get nothing but defeat. And they will not put a dent in the history of the Muslim Ummah. People will curse them. Allah will curse them and His angels will curse them. That's what Allah said in the Quran, not me. أولئك عليهم لعنة الله والملائكة والناس أجمعين. Brothers and sisters, these people will not. What we're doing here is the counterfeit to what they do there. And alhamdulillah that Allah is using us as a tool of goodness to make a history for the Ummah, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. So, I am not bothered that nobody is raising his hand. Because if nobody raised his hand with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who am I? I'm nobody. As a matter of fact, alhamdulillah, every time people raise their hands, mashaAllah. We've raised what? I would say anywhere between 6 to 7 million for this Islamic center, 2 million for the old land, and then 4 million here. MashaAllah, la quwata illa billah. We're very lucky. Because Rasulullah left us with goodness and he said, Al-khayru fiyya wa fi ummati ila yawm al-qiyamah. Goodness is in me and in my ummah. The goodness of Rasulullah is inside each and every one of you. Wallahi, if you think you're not religious, the goodness of Rasulullah is inside you. Whether you know it or not, whether you believe it or not, the goodness of Rasulullah is inside each and every one of you. You just have to act upon it and Allah will show you wonders and miracles. So alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. You see, mashallah, we're sitting down, drinking water, sipping coffee, and eating cheesecake, chicken breast, mashallah. And we raised what? $125,000, one third. Yani, if we just have two Uthman in the crowd, they'll take care of the other third and the other third. 100. And by the way, in this masjid, we raised $100,000 per person in one fundraising. Yes, we did it. It's no alien to this community to raise 100,000 per person. It happened and it will happen again, inshallah. Rabbil Alameen. I am absolutely not worried. Alhamdulillah. I think a lot with the weather and with the change of time, people got really knocked out tonight and they didn't come. But I'm very confident that inshallah, by the end of the 2-3 months, you would have raised. And Ramadan is coming, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah. Whatever we don't do tonight, we will do it in Ramadan. Very easily, Allah opens the hearts and soften the hearts on the night of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. So anyone did not donate, would like to donate, inshallah. 5,000, 2,000, 1,000, you know. Alhamdulillah,
You know, if everyone here who didn't donate, donates 1,000, khalas, we hit the 200,000 easily. No problem. It's the small donation that makes the big difference, you know, because it's distributed on the larger crowd. You know, instead of heavy, one person carry it, you know. So the brothers are going around with your credit card swipe or ATM machine or alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, plastic money. You can always, inshallah, donate, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. But I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, mashallah, keep it up. Keep MCC being active. Keep it being welcoming to the people who come in. Men, women, young, old. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Keep it spiritual and moist. Don't make it dry, right? Alhamdulillah, you have all the elements of success for an Islamic center to succeed. Alhamdulillah. All the elements of success, alhamdulillah, the hardworking people, the good intentions, the sincerity, the devotion, the dedication, it's going to happen, inshallah. La quwwata illa billah, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. I think, Brother Pervez and Brother Zahir, Siddiqui, how are we doing? Alhamdulillah. Khalas, any more donations coming, inshallah, rabbil alameen? Alhamdulillah. Khalas? MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. So, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and bless you for being patient, for sitting down. This is really, alhamdulillah, make dua for MCC, for our community, for our country, inshallah. Ya Allah, we ask you. This actually explains 150 to pay off Qard Hassan and 150 for remodeling funds, inshallah. That's if you wonder where the money is going, inshallah. اللهم ربنا يا رب العالمين بارك لنا في مجتمعنا هذا خاصة وفي سائر مجتمعات المسلمين اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا واجمع شملنا ووحد صفنا وأخرج الغل والحسد والحقد والكراهية والضغينة من بيننا يا رب العالمين اللهم أبعد عنا الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الغلا والوبا والزنا ومن غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن ومن العجز والكسل ومن الجبن والبخل ومن غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وحاضرنا وغائبنا يا رب العالمين اللهم واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اجعلها طهورا لهم ومغفرة لهم ورفعا لدرجاتهم يا رب العالمين اللهم احفظنا واحفظ أبناء وبنات المسلمين من كل شر وسوء وحرام يا رب العالمين اللهم احفظنا بالإسلام قائمين وقاعدين وراقدين وفي كل وقت وحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم آمين يا الله we ask you to bless our center يا رب العالمين and to bless all the other Islamic centers يا رب العالمين يا الله we ask you for your blessing and for your barakah to dwell between us يا رب العالمين Ya Allah, we ask you to show us the right path and to show us what we should do and what we should execute and what activities to do and what decisions to make. Be our guide, Ya Allah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, inspire us, energize us. Ya Allah, give us the vision and the understanding so that we will make this ummah a better ummah day by day, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, it is you whom we seek. And we only run from you to you, Ya Allah. You are the only God. You are our God. La ilaha illa ant subhanaka inna kunna min al-zalimin. Birahmatika arham al-rahimin. Ya Allah, bless the brothers, the sisters, the young, the old, everyone who helps and participate. Ya Allah, we ask you for our Muslim brothers and sisters who don't come to the masjid, that you inspire them to start coming to our centers and participate and witness the beauty and the love and the mercy between us, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, make us lights that you guide others with. Make us channels that you give mercy and forgiveness to others through. Ya Allah, make us minarets and make us lighthouses that will show the others and guide humanity to the truth and to you, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifuna Wa Salamun Al Mursaleen Wa Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين جزاكم الله